Greetings. Let's look at Psalms 2, verse 7. The King James Bible translation says, I will declare the decree, the Lord hath said unto me, Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. The Bible in Basic English says, I will make clear the Lord's decision he has said to me. You are my Son, this day have I given you being. I will tell you of the decree Yahweh said to me. You are my Son, today I have become your Father. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. He said to me, You are my Son, today I have become your Father. Let's look phrase by phrase at these four different translations. I will declare, I will make clear, I will make clear, I will proclaim. Who is speaking? This is Prophet David, because these are the Psalms. He says, I will declare, proclaim, or make clear. What? Make what clear? The decree. The Lord's decision of the decree of the Lord. So David said, I will declare the decree. The decree the Lord hath said unto me, the Lord's decision he has said to me, of the decree Yahweh said to me, the decree of the Lord, he said to me. Declare means to make known, to announce officially, to proclaim, to reveal or show, to make a declaration. Decree means a formal order, an authoritative order. In theology, one of the eternal purposes of God, by which events are foreordained. So David was saying, I will declare, reveal, or make known the decree, the formal and authoritative order which the Lord has given to me to deliver. What decree, what revelation, what message has God given to his prophet to deliver to the people? Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. You are my Son, this day have I given you being. You are my Son, today I have become your Father. This can mean one of two things. God has that very day given birth to David, or Dawood, who is now God's Son. Or Prophet David is revealing the Son of God, who will one day be begotten by God. Number one does not make sense for several reasons. When David revealed this, he was a grown man and already a prophet. He was already a prophet. And clearly, on the day he revealed this, he was neither born nor begotten. David was a prophet, and prophets are messengers, and messengers bring messages. Specifically, messages for others. If you call yourself Muslim, do you believe that Prophet Muhammad was given the Quran just for himself? No. Prophet Muhammad brought the Quran for all mankind. His message was for others. Very well then. David was a prophet. He was a prophet and he was given a message. His message was for others to reveal the future. Therefore, David is delivering God's decree of one day having a begotten son. But why would David bother to say, I will declare the decree? Because David was a monotheistic Jew. God's decree to reveal his begotten son was hard even for David to accept. You can almost hear the argument within David as God's word came to him. David, I am the Lord. Submit to me and deliver my decree. Yes, Lord, I am your servant. I will declare your message. David, I want you to reveal my son. No, God. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is one. As my servant, reveal my son who will come later. But Lord, I will be called a false prophet. David, obey me and submit, and reveal my son. But Lord, I will be the only prophet to say, you have a son. They will stone me. David, other prophets have revealed my son as well. Read the Shema. The truth is even there, David. Very well, Lord. I will submit to you as your prophet. I will declare the decree that you, the Lord, have said to me, thou art my son. This day have I begotten thee. But I don't know what it means, Lord. I don't know what it means. But as your prophet, I'll reveal your message even though I don't understand. But this verse creates problems for Islam, because the founder of Islam claimed God has no son. Yet Islam claims David is a prophet. And Surah 4:163 says, and to David we gave the book of Psalms. So the Quran states the Psalms are the word of God, and David is a prophet. If this verse speaks of David, then God has declared David is his begotten son, and God has a son. If this verse speaks of Jesus, which is the common knowledge in all Christianity, this is what the verse is speaking about, then God has declared he will have a begotten son, and therefore again, God has a son. If you call yourself Muslim, whichever way you read it, this verse contradicts Muhammad's claim that God has no son. Both ways of reading this verse mean that God has a son, and therefore Muhammad and the Quran are wrong. You may decide whether you believe Jesus is the Son of God or David is the Son of God. But either way, one who says God has no son is simply wrong. If you call yourself Muslim, you must decide whether you believe Muhammad or Prophet David. You cannot believe both because one refutes the other. But know this, the correct reading of this verse is that God will send his begotten Son into the world, the Lord Jesus Christ. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who was revealed by the prophet David in Psalms 2:7. Amen.